Have you ever wondered about the invisible force holding our universe together? What if I told you that most of the universe is made of something we can't see or even detect directly? Welcome to the mysterious world of dark matter. In this video, I will explain dark matter and the mysteries it contains. So stay tuned until the end so you won't miss any exciting parts. First, let's look at what dark matter is. Dark matter is a form of matter that makes up to 27% of the universe. Dark matter does not interact with electromagnetic forces, unlike ordinary matter, which consists of protons, neutrons, and electrons. It means it doesn't absorb, reflect, or emit light while making it completely invisible. On the other hand, ordinary matter forms everything we see around us: stars, planets, galaxies, and all the objects on Earth. The distinction lies in their interaction with fundamental forces. Ordinary matter interacts with electromagnetic, weak, and strong forces, whereas dark matter primarily interacts through gravity. Let's see some of the characteristics of dark matter. Dark matter possesses several intriguing properties that set it apart from ordinary matter. Firstly, it is invisible because it does not emit, absorb, or reflect electromagnetic radiation. Secondly, dark matter is non-baryonic, which means it is not composed of baryons, the particles, like protons and neutrons, that make up ordinary matter. Its exact composition remains one of the biggest mysteries in physics. Despite its invisibility, dark matter exerts gravitational forces while influencing stars' motion within galaxies. Additionally, dark matter interacts very weakly, making it incredibly difficult to detect directly. Do you know about one of the fantastic dark matter halo concepts? Stars in the outer part of galaxies move faster than expected based on the visible matter, indicating a lot of unseen mass present. Well, here it is, the dark matter halo. Dark matter halos are essential for understanding the structure and behavior of galaxies. These halos are large, invisible regions made up of dark matter that surround galaxies and stretch far beyond what we can see. These halos provide the necessary gravitational pull to explain the observed rotational speeds. Moreover, it helps stabilize galaxies and keep them from flying apart under their rotational forces. These halos also affect the path of light from background objects, a phenomenon known as gravitational lensing. By studying these lensing effects, astronomers can map the distribution and density of dark matter in these halos. Dark matter halos are essential because of their role in the formation of galaxies. They also provide the gravitational framework within which galaxies can form and grow, while influencing the distribution and behavior of ordinary matter during the early stages of galaxy formation. Let's see some evidence that provides the existence of dark matter. Much evidence proves the existence of dark matter, one of which is the study of the galaxy rotation curves. Astronomers find something when they observe the rotational speed of stars within galaxies. According to the laws of gravity and the distribution of visible matter, stars on the outer edges of galaxies should rotate more slowly than those near the center, where most of the visible mass is concentrated. However, observations reveal that stars in the outer regions of galaxies are rotating at much higher velocities than expected. This discrepancy suggests the additional unseen mass exerting gravitational influence prevents the stars from flying apart due to their high speeds. Well, it is dark matter. Dark matter is essential because it creates the right amount of gravity, which explains how galaxies spin the way they do. Without dark matter, our current understanding of gravitational dynamics would be insufficient. Thus, the study of galaxy rotation curves significantly highlights the presence of dark matter and its essential role in the structure and behavior of galaxies. On the other hand, the cosmic microwave background radiation is another piece of evidence that dark matter exists in the cosmic world. The CBM is the unclear glow that was emitted after the Big Bang. It is a faint radiation that spreads throughout the universe. By studying the fluctuations and patterns in the CMB, scientists can infer the distribution of matter and energy in the early universe. The detailed observations of the CMB, made by missions such as the Wilkinson Microwave Antistrophe Probe, reveal slight temperature variations. These variations correspond to regions of different densities in the early universe. The data from the CMB show that ordinary, visible matter makes up only a tiny portion of the total matter in the universe. The rest must be made up of something else that does not emit or interact with light: dark matter. The distribution and behavior of these density fluctuations in the CMB align with predictions made by the dark matter model. Dark matter plays a crucial role in shaping the formation of large cosmic structures in the universe. Before proceeding to the video's next part, let's subscribe to the channel, press the bell icon, and join us on the journey to the cosmic world. Let's see the role of dark matter in creating the galaxy and the cosmic world. The gravitational pull of the dark matter is an essential part for the formation of the galaxies and the cosmos. In the early universe, fluctuations in the density of dark matter provided the initial framework upon which galaxies could form. These fluctuations attract ordinary matter to form dense regions where stars and galaxies eventually emerge. Within galaxies, dark matter's gravitational pull affects the orbits of stars. This influence is evident in the rotation curves of galaxies, where the presence of dark matter ensures that stars in the outer regions rotate at speeds consistent with those closer to the center. Now, let's examine in detail the impact of dark matter on the universe's large-scale structure. Dark matter constructs the foundational framework of the cosmic web while defining the vast structure of the universe. Its gravitational influence shapes the distribution of galaxies and clusters across cosmic distances. The universe exhibits a web-like pattern of filaments and voids, where galaxies and clusters are found along dark matter filaments. Observations indicate a close correlation between the distribution of galaxies and the underlying dark matter scaffolding, highlighting the essential role of dark matter in shaping the cosmic world. As the universe continues to evolve, dark matter's gravitational pull influences the growth and interaction of structures, from the smallest galaxies to the most significant galaxy clusters. Now let's focus on one of the most critical questions. What are the main differences between dark matter and dark energy? Dark matter and energy are distinct components, yet they play fundamentally different roles in cosmic evolution. Dark matter interacts primarily through gravity, exerting a gravitational pull that binds galaxies and structures together over cosmic distances. It acts as the gravitational glue that enables the formation of galaxies. In contrast, dark energy is a mysterious force accelerating the universe's expansion. Unlike dark matter, which attracts matter gravitationally, dark energy is a repulsive force that drives galaxies apart and contributes to accelerated expansion. Together, dark matter and energy form the majority of the energy of the universe's mass, while highlighting the profound questions and challenges for cosmologists seeking to understand our universe's ultimate fate and structure. Moreover, dark matter can be detected by direct and indirect detection. Direct detection experiments represent a crucial factor in the search for dark matter particles. These experiments operate on the principle that dark matter is composed of particles and interacts with ordinary matter. The goal is to capture and study these rare interactions, manifesting as small signals in sensitive detectors. These detectors are buried deep underground to protect them from cosmic rays and other background radiation. These detectors are designed to detect faint energy deposits or light emissions resulting from potential dark matter interactions with atomic nuclei. On the other hand, indirect detection methods offer an alternative approach to observing dark matter by observing its secondary effects rather than directly detecting the particles. The main idea of indirect detection is based on the possibility that dark matter particles can annihilate one another or decay into detectable products such as gamma rays, neutrinos, or cosmic rays. High-energy particle colliders also play a crucial role in the search for dark matter. By smashing particles together at incredibly high speeds, scientists hope to create dark matter particles and observe their interactions while providing valuable clues about their properties. Moreover, gravitational lensing is another indirect method used to detect dark matter. When light from distant objects, such as galaxies, passes through a region with a significant amount of dark matter, it bends due to the gravitational pull. By studying these distortions, scientists can map out the distribution of dark matter and gain insights into its properties. Future missions and technological advancements are working for dark matter detection. Next-generation detectors, improved particle colliders, and advanced space telescopes are expected to enhance the ability to detect and understand dark matter. What other unresolved mysteries and challenges are associated with dark matter? The most important is the mystery surrounding the nature of dark matter particles themselves. Despite extensive theoretical models, such as weakly interacting massive particles or axions, none of them have been conclusively detected. It leads to ongoing debates and experimental and theoretical research efforts to identify and characterize these elusive particles. Detection methods represent another significant hurdle, the daunting task of distinguishing the signals from background noise. Meanwhile, indirect detection strategies rely on observing secondary effects like gamma rays or high-energy particles produced by dark matter annihilation or decay. These methods require sophisticated analysis and robust theoretical frameworks to differentiate potential dark matter signals from astrophysical backgrounds. Moreover, observational data suggests that dark matter forms halos around galaxies and clusters, influencing their gravitational dynamics. So mapping these distributions is essential for validating cosmological models. Let's recall the crucial pointers from today's video. Dark matter remains a big puzzle in our study of the universe. We can't see it directly because it doesn't emit light or interact with regular matter in detectable ways. Instead, we know it exists because of its gravitational effect on visible objects like stars and galaxies. Currently, scientists face several challenges. They are trying to determine what dark matter is made of, develop better ways to detect it directly, and map out its location in the universe. Moreover, advances in technology, such as better neutrino detectors and particle colliders, also offer promising avenues for studying dark matter further. Researchers are optimistic about solving the mysteries of dark matter by working together across different scientific fields and using new tools. The study of dark matter will reveal other mysteries of the cosmic world that are still hidden in the universe. So there you have it, guys. Share your thoughts and questions in the comments section.